If you've seen Netflix's QB1 Beyond the Lights, you're pretty familiar with former Pinnacle High School and current Oklahoma Sooner quarterback Spencer Rattler. Spencer was featured on the streaming service and gave viewers a chance to see his personality and his playing ability under a microscope. We all know he can play football, and we all know he's not short on confidence, but on this list, we're going to focus on the top 10 things we didn't know about the rising star. Before we jump into all things Spencer Rattler, go ahead and click that subscribe button so you can get the latest and greatest from our channel. All done? Let's get into it. Spencer Rattler was receiving offers from major schools while he was still a freshman in high school. A freshman. Let that sink in for a little bit. Most freshmen don't even get a chance to play on a varsity squad, let alone start. But an opportunity opened up for Spencer after he attended Pinnacle High School's football team for their summer workouts. The previous starting quarterback was no longer on the team, and this gave Spencer the opportunity he needed to shine. His freshman year may have started out with a blowout loss, but Rattler continued to improve and went on to have a productive freshman year. After being widely regarded as one of the top QBs in the nation, Spencer received his first verbal offer from UCLA. Can you imagine receiving a verbal offer from UCLA around the same age you're barely old enough to get your driver's license? It wasn't long before his hometown college of Arizona State University would show interest in the rising star. This is the type of intrigue that followed the quarterback since he hit high school. The hype surrounding him would only pick up steam after he continued to show out on the field. Many other offers began rolling in for the Rattler as he improved as a quarterback and catapulted his name into the national spotlight. Spencer's first coach was his dad. Spencer Rattler started playing football at the age of 7 years old after his dad asked him if he wanted to play tackle or flag football. He decided to go with tackle, and he never looked back. His first position was quarterback, and Spencer stuck with that during his whole playing career. After getting coached up as much as he could by his dad and realizing he had a real knack for the game and the position, Rattler took his game more seriously and started working with Arizona quarterback guru Mike Giovando, whom he still works with whenever he's back in Arizona. Spencer has claimed that he wouldn't be where he is today without his QB coach, who he credited for giving him the fundamentals, mechanics, and teaching him how to read defenses. The QB is a trick shot artist. If you've watched any of Rattler's high school highlights, you will see the many absurd throws and arm talent that makes him one of the most exciting prospects in college sports. Whether he's throwing off balance on one leg or jumping to complete a pass, it's hard not to see that Rattler is as good as all the buzz about him suggests. When a couple of trick shot videos surfaced to the young QB, we saw just how phenomenal of an arm this QB has. The trick shots also showcase his deep passing accuracy by throwing a football into a trash can from the side of a mountain, or his versatility by making ridiculous behind-the-back passes. He also showed that he can do some of these things blindfolded. People have questioned the validity of the infamous trash can throw, but all of the others seem legit. Real or not, what is certain is that Rattler is a showman off the field when he's not showing out on it. Spencer chose the University of Oklahoma because of Lincoln Riley. We talked about how the offers were rolling in for Spencer early on and often during his high school career, but one college eventually stood out above the others, and that's the University of Oklahoma. And the thing that sold Rattler on attending the university was the coach himself, Lincoln Riley. Riley, a noted quarterback whisperer, made the decision easy for Spencer Rattler, and the timing could not have worked out more perfectly, as Riley has just recently been promoted to head coach during Rattler's stint at Pinnacle. Less than 2 weeks after accepting the position, Riley brought Spencer and his family for a campus visit, and the rest, well, the rest was history. Riley's success spoke for itself after recently turning Baker Mayfield into one of the best quarterbacks in the country. After redshirting his freshman year, Rattler is the starting quarterback for the 2020 season. All signs point to Riley having similar success with Rattler as he did with Oklahoma's previous quarterback prospects, and all eyes will be on both coach and quarterback as the Sooners take the field this season. Spencer Rattler was suspended for his final year of high school. Whether you're familiar with Spencer Rattler for his high school success or tune into Netflix's QB1 Beyond the Lights, you might have heard that the quarterback was suspended on the eve of senior night during his final season at Pinnacle High School and deemed ineligible to play the remainder of the year. What you may not know is that Spencer was asked not to speak on the suspension by school administrators, which has only added to the mystery surrounding it. Spencer did speak on the issue and gave as much information as he could regarding the matter, stating, "A day or two before the ESPN game, I messed up. It was a code of conduct rule, and I was ineligible, not suspended. It was a childish and dumb mistake." Rattler initially lied about the incident, saying he sat out of the game due to an MCL injury as administrators and his parents felt that that was the best approach. The speculation is that Spencer may have been involved with drugs or alcohol, as those are the only codes that result in the type of suspension that Spencer was up against. It's unknown if he will ever get to the bottom of this story, but it was enough to keep a star as big as he was in Phoenix from finishing his final season. One can only wonder how dumb this mistake really was. Spencer Rattler can't live without God. When Rattler was asked about the top 10 things in life he couldn't live without, number one on the list was the man upstairs. Rattler answered the question without hesitation and put him up at the top of the list. On his Instagram page, the phrase, "God got me," in all caps, is even on his bio. Notably, not on the list of 10 things he couldn't live without was football. Perhaps he's wanting us to assume that's a given. Rattler was a standout basketball player in high school. We all know that Spencer can ball out on the football field. What you may not know about the Oklahoma Sooner quarterback is that during high school, he was also a stud on the basketball court. He helped lead his team to a 6A state championship his junior year after winning the title. How did Spencer celebrate? By going on Twitter to announce his retirement from the sport. Not sure if high school players announce their retirement, but who doesn't want to go out on top? The tweet, "Hoop career ended with the ring." As good as Spencer might have been, he was better at football, so if he retired to focus on his better sport, don't think anyone would be too mad at that. Rattler was the first Arizona quarterback to ever surpass the 11,000-yard mark. When you're the first to ever do something as far as records are concerned, you're probably great at it. Rattler was the first from the state to cross the 11,000-yard threshold and did it in style in a 19-point come-from-behind victory. He eclipsed the 11,000-yard mark, and if not for a suspension-shortened season, he could have piled on more yards to that total. Spencer Rattler has enormous shoes to fill in Oklahoma, that's for sure. In 2017, Oklahoma produced a Heisman winner in quarterback Baker Mayfield. In 2018, Oklahoma produced another Heisman winner in quarterback Kyler Murray. Not only did they both win Heismans, but they were also the first quarterbacks selected in their respective NFL drafts. If you're Spencer Rattler, you've got to know that the bar has already been set through the roof for you when you're the team's primary signal caller. After being named the starting quarterback on September 1st, Rattler will be expected to be in the Heisman conversation, along with those two Heisman winners. The pressure's on, and the sports world will be watching to see if Lincoln Riley and the quarterback he handpicked before his junior season of high school can reach the level of previous Oklahoma Sooner greats. Oh yeah, in 2019, the QB that got the starting nod over Rattler, Heisman runner-up Jalen Hurts. Pinnacle High School offensive coordinator Mike Brown thinks Spencer Rattler is the next Patrick Mahomes. Could there be any higher praise than being compared to the nearly $500 million man? Brown notes Rattler's swag, pocket presence, arm strength, and accuracy remind him of the Super Bowl winning Kansas City Chiefs quarterback. He also claims Rattler has the moxie and overall confidence that you need to be great. While Rattler was redshirting at the University of Oklahoma last year and his team nearly blew a 20-point lead, Brown texted the former Pinnacle quarterback after the game, and Rattler said if he was in the game, they would have killed the other team. Like him or not, that's the kind of confidence you want from your starting quarterback. Now in the driver's seat, we'll see if Rattler can be Pat Mahomes-esque this football season. And that is our list, 10 things you didn't know about Netflix series star and former Pinnacle High School superstar, Spencer Rattler. Love this list. Hate this list. Drop us a line and let us know your thoughts. As Spencer Rattler's career continues, we are sure there will be much more to add to this list. Stay safe out there, football fans. Until next time.